strand? What? Look at my container, bro.
What's my log car? That's my girl's log car.
Double-ended black dildo was like, kick you, dirty dick.
Don't talk about 611 like that.
Yeah, it's like a two, it's only fine. Oh no, I'm not- fucking know every minute of it.
Yeah.
It was not good.
Ah, you're fine. Don't be a baby.
I'm fine. Yeah, it hurt. It hurt a lot.
By then they've had, you know, a million plus miles on it.
Oh yeah.
because I mean you can run them for what you can run them for 92 days before they have to get taken out for inspection. So you know, figure constant run, constant overload, because you know, heaven forbid, MS runs a train with enough power.
Well,
and CSX overpowers.
No, because they don't.
Sometimes.
Yeah, but you'd express.
Yeah. Yeah, but not always, because I mean, you know, you'll see the trains that have power moves, so they'll have like eight units, but only two are.
I'm a firm believer that you should always have more power than you need.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Just well, to be safe.
When I bought my 387, I bought it the first trip I made. I went to Joplin, Missouri. Shop Mafia. They decked me out all kinds of chrome. All tanks, all wheels, all covered, all chromed out. They had a guy, Eric, who was doing the top convention. Bond's coming to 625 horsepower. So, how many was done? I was there for like another six. Better in there.
Yeah, what? Well, five?
No, no, actually better.
Really?
More horsepower in that truck, that less than had to work. So, pulling hose is easier. Well, it's like 6.5, 7. But I also do short shift a lot when I drive a truck. I do a lot of short shifting when I drive. I don't try to run down when I have to.
Right.
When you're busy, you don't run it all the way up. You just 1800 and shift. 1800 shift. Keep your fuel mileage here, too. You wouldn't have to really rev it out when I was pulling up the Rockies. You don't like too many gears.
Hey, it's all fun and games. Just get that gear going back to me.
Hope you have good brakes.
Yeah. Oh, well, I hope your jigs can.
You're not gearing, your jigs ain't doing shit.
Well, that's true.
I had a friend, a student one time. He gave me a student. Guy couldn't shift it off. How'd you get that driving shift? And he missed the ship going down Fancy Gap in North Carolina.
Yeah.
13%.
That's dangerous.
Thank God we were light.
Pounds of batteries in the back or lead, you've been fucked. You've been gone.
Granted, there's like 9 ramps on that ramp, so you play these to stop, but my truck, I ain't wrecking it for nobody. I pretty much called the company and said, look, he's not driving, he's fucking done. He can't shift, he can't turn, he's done.
It's your authority.
Well, yeah, a road test examiner, I got to make sure they're good for road tests.
Yeah.
Now, the trainer, if they don't pass my scrutiny, they don't get in my truck. I had one girl who was amazing at driving. I'm not saying girls can't drive, but, like, she could drive. And I was like, well, I'm going to send a message on my phone. And I had nothing to worry about. She's good. She's on point. She knew her shifts. She knew her turns. I'm like, she told me her backstory where she lived on a farm growing up. So she
knew.
She was,